Viral outbreaks have been topping the news for some time now. In November 2002, a farmer from a small city in China died from what was then an unknown respiratory disease. Later, the medical community would recognize the incident as ground zero in the SARS outbreak. More recently, a new strain of influenza moved from pigs, its natural host, to humans, H1N1, also known as swine flu, quickly spread around the world. Millions contracted the disease and thousands died. Science and biotechnology provide us with the tools necessary to analyze, understand, and build new vaccines to combat viruses as they emerge. We've chosen you as a new member of the National Laboratory of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics to use science to identify new viral threats and help us stop outbreaks before they occur. Welcome to Mission Biotech. For Newswatch WMDT, I'm Sal Mania.
No. The centrifuge spins your sample tubes at high speeds, but it must be properly balanced to avoid damaging the equipment. Click and drag your patient's sample tube into a centrifuge slot. Fill a clean, empty tube with the same amount of water as your patient's sample tube. Place this tube into the centrifuge slot, directly opposite the first tube. Set the centrifuge to spin your tube at the desired settings. Click and hold the arrows to change the numbers, or type them in using your keyboard. Click the Start button to start the centrifuge. Once the centrifuge is finished, you can click and drag the tubes back to your inventory, or simply click the Remove All button.
Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.